Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire que les objectifs du développement durable, les
What
ODD,
does it mean
sont
that the SDGs,
eh bien, ça veut dire
when one says that they're universal? Well, it simply means that they have been adopted by every country in the world. They are goals for every country in the world. Unlike the previous goals, the Millennium Development Goals, adopted in the year 2000, that's not quite right, because already the MDGs were already universal objectives for every country, but they were perceived by public opinion as being objectives for developing countries. And in fact, even seemed to be a concern for international aid. And there was a clear reason for that. This idea of goals, of development goals, had come, had emerged at the end of the 90s, because the 1990s, after the Berlin Wall fell, it resulted in a sharp drop in international aid. It was called aid fatigue. And that is why the MDGs were very much associated with international aid. And in fact, things worked quite well, because starting in the year 2000, with the MDGs, international aid rose. It didn't quite reach its former levels, but the trend remains upward.
So,
every country adopted these SDGs. Does that mean that every country is a developing country? The notion may seem rather shocking. Go and tell Somalia that the US are a developing country. They might find that slightly shocking. Depends what you mean by development. We're talking here about sustainable development. The so-called northern countries have as many efforts to become environmentally sustainable than lesser developed countries. I'm sure you're familiar with this graph, you've seen it before. You have on the upward axis the level of human development, the HDI, and you can see here the red line, which shows the threshold of human development, according to the UN, which is about 0.8. And then, vertically, you have the consumption, you have what is known as the environmental footprint, and in order for planet to be sustainable, you should not go beyond the red lines. So, in order to be in a sustainable development situation, you need to be in that top left-hand corner. And no country is in there. And it kind of creates an impression that all of the countries who have succeeded to go beyond the 0.8 HDI followed the same path, and they did so by adopting a model of development that is unsustainable. You can see the path here. It's this orange arrow. What does that mean? It means that there's a huge challenge, particularly for countries who are in the middle here, to try to, because they are the closest, in fact, to the top left-hand corner. And they are the ones that need to speed up in trying to achieve that. And it's, in fact, for the more developed countries that things will probably be the most difficult.
Ça veut dire pratiquement inverser la marche actuelle.
You need to reverse the path they're following. And it's also difficult for countries who have not yet reached the right level of development. So they must develop, and they must also reach sustainable development, because the countries here in the middle of the curve are hurtling down the road. $20 trillion are saved and invested on Earth every year. And in fact, if we hurtle along that road, we're going to crash right in the wall. And therefore, the path towards the global goals requires
Combien ça coûte? On n'en sait rien.
The road to turn, probably not trillions of trillions, but it will require the political will to invent new models, both for developing countries, emerging economies, and poor countries. So every country is making a commitment that is greater for developed nations because all of them are committed to reach these SDGs on the, in their own country, in poverty, health, and so on. They also are going to contribute to the oceans, the air, the water, and they also commit to helping poorer countries to reach their own SDGs and to produce common goods, notably the poorest countries. And this commitment even has its own SDG, SDG 17, about partnerships that need to be created to obtain the goals with rules of international trade, sharing technology and accessing development funding. And one of the forms of funding is international aid. So the SDGs, from this respect, also offer a new framework for international aid. When I say also, I say also because it applies to every country, but also internationally, and also because the SDGs are an international framework in themselves. So in a sense, they explain the P, public aid to development. We know what public aid to development is. What type of development? Development as described by the 17 SDGs and the 169 goals in these SDGs. In 2015, there was an international agreement with every country in the world about what development meant, which is a sensational result. That was something that simply did not exist before. So every country needs to draw its own roadmap towards its own SDGs. What they need to do is to define the path towards these goals, particularly in terms of the climate, under the Climate Accord in Paris, of course, in the same year. And the role of the international aid agencies is to provide support to developing nations to help them follow that path and to help them reach the goals nationally, domestically. So ultimately, what must one remember? The key takeaways. Every country is committed to these sustainable development goals. They are not all expected to take the same path to reach them. France, for instance, at the moment, with the General Commissariat for Sustainable Development, is drawing up a French roadmap for these SDGs. For countries such as France, there's a dual responsibility for the so-called northern countries, reaching one's own domestic SDGs and participating in the common good, but also assisting poorer countries with through policies and international aid. And as we're talking about international aid has a renewed framework to support developing countries on the path to these SDGs, because these SDGs repeat the historic commitment to spend 0.7% of national wealth in international aid.
À l'aide internationale pour les pays en développement.